Hello, this is the LEGO Creator Lighthouse Point Set, and it is a 3-in-1, so in this one video I will be showing you 3 official builds. This one here is called Boathouse, or I guess you could call it Houseboat. It's the smallest and least parts intensive, and it's definitely the least attractive, the least good looking of all of them. I guess that's why it's build number 3 and not number 1. It does come with its own lighthouse though, or little light signal, which has a light brick in it, and you push the button and light comes out from one side, nice and bright. I like those light bricks, but you know, it's just a little thing on the side, which is cool. The general idea with a houseboat is that it doesn't move very much. It's mostly a house that floats, usually built on a barge base or something like that. So it's not supposed to look sleek. It's not supposed to look fast. They don't even have to have motors on them. Sometimes people will add an outboard on at some point, but most of the time they'll just be towed around or they won't move at all throughout their entire life. When you look at this from this lower angle like this, it makes a lot more sense. You're not able to open up the roof on it. The roof does not come off. It's not designed to come off whatsoever. However, they do let you open up the side. So that's how you get to see inside. For details, there's a picture up on the wall, and I believe that's supposed to be above a bed right here. This small little thing just in one corner. On the other side, there's a table with a coffee mug and a jar of something, and that's just it. This doesn't work well with the figures because it's tough to get your fingers inside to get them posed, and even the bed is much too short for a minifigure to lay there, so you try to put somebody there, and okay, all of his legs and his hips are completely off. Close this. And he just fell in. Even a child figure doesn't work well there, especially with the hair that's included here. The best thing you can do, I think, for posing up a figure to make this look lived in and alive is to very carefully get your, try to get the hands up, get your finger around there and get a figure posed on one of the decks, front or back. And even this is proving a little bit difficult. There we go, got it. Get the hair back on there. Close this up real quick. Okay, whew, done. This one's a lot more conventional to look at. It has a little speedboat off to the side, which makes good use of some of the spare parts from this build. You even have an outboard motor simulated there, which can be brought up if you bring this thing on land. It even has a little bit of simulation for the console in the front of the thing for driving around and seeing what's going on. So that's cool. And then this is just a small house that's elevated up a little bit. Got a little bit of a pier here on the side, which looks nice. This does have the light brick also integrated into it. You can push from the back, from the other side, to get that to turn on. So it's just a light for the porch, basically. You know, it's just a little lamp on the front. Does have some windows around the side. You know, this isn't the most clean looking thing, but it's not bad. You know, at least the colors are kind of kept together. Got a little bit of texture on the back here, just making good use of the parts, and I think that looks fine. Nice big, almost bay style window, except there's no framing whatsoever, and there's a plant inside of there. And this one is also able to open up. I really like the shore around here, but this is able to open up right here, which shows you some nice interior detail. See, there's that same picture up on the wall, but there's also a fireplace with some fire and some firewood off to the side. Got the, you know, the whole chimney stack going up, and on the other side, a little bit more of a proper table and space to put a couple coffee mugs there. And even some kind of interior lighting, like a sconce almost looks like on the side there. So that's cool. I also appreciate the use of these window frames to help hold the whole thing up. This is just well done with the parts and with the look, you know. This could actually be sold as just a smaller creator set, I feel. Last up, here's the big one, and I need to address the 800-pound orca in the room. This is another assembly that I feel is good enough to be sold just by itself. This is pretty perfect. Maybe the dorsal fin is a little bit tall, but oh well, not a big deal. You can articulate it quite significantly, including turning the tail off to the side because it has a ball joint used there. Also ball joints used here and here, and also for the lower jaw. So not only can you open the jaw up like that, and I love the inverted pink round tile that's used there, that's perfect. Almost looks like he's got his teeth going around the front here also, with just the upside down round slope piece there. I don't know if that's intentional, but it's great. It works out really well. Of course, you can change how you attach the eyes if you want to make it look like it's looking forward a little bit more, but so you can kind of rotate the jaw around as well. This is just, like I said, just something that would be nice all by itself. The main structure is once again right on the seashore, and there's a bit of a deck or dock off to one side. Nice little detailing in here. It's simple, it's small, but it looks really good. And it takes some work and some experimentation. Good look to the main house structure itself, just in general from the outside. And there are a couple of these seagull builds. So one of them's on top of the house right now, and the other one's all the way up here at the very tippy top of the lighthouse structure itself. The lighthouse does light up, of course. It uses the light brick in there, and that's here. Lights up nice and tall, you know, creates a really good scene. This is not a perfectly round structure. I would love if it was perfectly round, but I'm perfectly fine with it not being perfectly round because you're able to get these windows in there and a little bit of texture on the side for where some of the paint has started to fall off. It's actually a little bit of a modular build here with each of these colored sections because they use tiles in between and the tiles that have just a couple of studs on them. So you can actually take this off at any point and you can put a small figure in there. These actually have plates on the bases of them, so it's not a whole lot of space you can use in there. I think that's an adult figure can sit down inside of there, but you know, not a lot of usable space, but it is kind of a cool, fun build there. And coming around the back, more shore structure, and this has more foliage with a little bit of grassy area back here. You know, it's just a backyard, or is this actually the front? You can kind of choose. I guess you could see this being as more of the front, but good little bit of detail, and once again, a fireplace, and this time it's a fire pit on the outside. You can open this up. Now, when you open it up, before I show you the interior, it kind of looks good on display like this as well. It's a way to see the entire set in somewhat of a larger way. If you're only ever going to see it from one side, this is nice. Rather than just opening it up all the way, you know, having a little bit of angle to it, I think gives it a little extra personality and life. On the inside, there's not a lot to see. It's much better looking from the outside for sure, but you know, just again, another table. That same picture up on the wall, of course, another table off to the corner. That's a good use of that small space. And then there's a sextant that's up on the wall over here. The only thing that I don't like about the look of this from the outside, especially from this side, which is mostly good looking, is just how far the activator for the light sticks out. That could have been a smaller piece for sure. You know, it's sticking out almost one length or one width longer than it really needs to. Now, I mentioned that the main tower structure is modular. Where there are some other modular things here as well, because they use the Technic bricks all around the base of this. And I'll just go ahead and make sure that this is even. All this pulls off, so you can actually attach this in different places. So if I want to put this over on this side, now I can do that. I can actually bring this up. Becomes not the most inviting exit over here, but yes, see, can do that. So kind of a modular build to the base here. This part here is also attached in that way, so you can do some things with kind of the leftover, and this back here is also attached in that way. So if I wanted to bring this around to this side right here, yes, that's what I wanted. So there you go. Just completely changed the configuration of this thing. The only one thing that's not nice about all that is that this becomes kind of flimsy looking and feeling from the outside. This is just part of the modularity of the build there, but the base, you know, things don't really connect together that well. It's not a big deal, just a little subjective feel thing. Lastly, here's a closer look at the figures, just so you can see exactly which prints are used on these. And interestingly, they don't actually swap the parts, like the torsos between them, torsos and hair pieces between them, in their suggestions for the different build options, but that's fine. So the smallest build here feels a bit like an afterthought to me, but it is nice to at least have a little bit of suggestion of creativity, kind of pushing folks beyond the box of doing something other than just another type of house. The second build in the middle, it looks really good to me. It does leave a bunch of parts behind, but it does look nice and feels like it could stand alone. The main build is just so much better than the other two. It's really difficult to compare them at all. The main build is obviously the one that you want to go for, and you know, you can easily customize from there just by moving things around on the outside. That's a really nice idea. Not the first time that they've done something like that, and I hope that they will continue to try to do things like that, because it's really, really convenient to do just minor, you know, reconfigurations. I did notice that the price to part ratio is surprisingly high for a creator set. You know, prices of a lot of things have gone up, but creator has remained a pretty good value in general. This one is creeping up there. This one's in the middle to high range for what you would expect for a city set. So that's a little bit unexpected for me. I know that you do have to pay extra for the light brick that has some extra value, so that probably accounts for it, but I hope that Creator will remain a value leader because it deserves to. And LEGO fans in general need to have some kind of theme that has lower prices. That's it for my look at this set though. Please do leave your thoughts, what you think about the three builds and the set on the whole, as well as its value. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this, and I look forward to your feedback. Talk to you again soon.